The screen is visible. Students, is it visible?
Yes, sir.
Okay, I'll discuss this problem. Okay, so here they will give a cyclic process. Okay, but before that, you see the problem number 5. Okay, for the following process in a closed system, find the missing data. You see some of the data they will give and some data they are missing. Actually, here Q is missing, and then in a U1 for the process B is missing. Like that, they'll give some missing term. You have to fill the term. Okay, so before that, we should know the first law of thermodynamic undergoing a closed system in a change of state. Remember, we are having two formula. One is closed system undergoing in a cyclic process, that is cyclic integral of dq equals to cyclic integral of dw. It's nothing but q1 plus q2 plus q3 and so on equals to w1 plus w2 and so on. Okay, that is the formula. That is summation of heat transfer in a closed cyclic process equals to the summation of work transfer. Okay, remember, this formula holds good for the closed system undergoing in a cyclic process. On the other hand, whenever the process undergoing a change of state, you have to remember the formula Q equals to delta U plus W. Okay, so you remember, these are the two simple formula to remember. Okay, Q equals to delta U plus W. Q is heat transfer, delta U is change in internal energy, that is nothing but U2 minus U1, and plus W is your work transfer. Okay, so here there are four process, cyclic process. Okay, so for the process they are given W, U1, U2 and delta U. So you have to find out Q. Actually, Q is a missing data. You have to find out Q in the process A. Okay, so you have to apply the formula. For all the process, you have to apply the same formula, that is Q equals to delta U plus W. As I said, delta U is nothing but U2 minus U1 plus W1. Now you see the given data in the problem. Okay, here U2 minus U1. Okay, U2 minus U1 is nothing but what? 5 minus of minus 10. Okay, it is nothing but 5 plus 10. U2 minus U1 is 15. Okay, and you have to find out U2 as 5. Okay. Next, how to find out Q? Q is delta U plus W. Okay, see, there are 5 values are given. Okay, Q, delta U, U1, U2 and delta U. Delta U is nothing but U2 minus of U1. In the given problem, for the process, say, two are the unknown things. One is Q and one is U2. Okay, first, what you can do, apply the formula Q equals to delta U plus W. Okay, U2 minus U1 is nothing but 15. Delta U is directly given. You can take 15 plus W1 to 2 is your 20. Okay, so 35 kilojoule is there. Okay, then how, what is the unknown thing? U2. U2 minus U1 is 15. Okay, U1 we know, minus 10. And how to find out U2? U2 is nothing but 5. Like that, you have to find out for the process A. Okay, that is a very simple formula. Q equals to delta U plus W. Okay. Next, for the process B. Okay, here for the process B, Q is given, W is given, U1 is unknown, U2 is given, and delta U is unknown. Like that, they give two unknown quantity. Okay, so you have to find out those values. Okay, for the process B, Q is 15, W is minus 6, and U1 is minus 27, U2 is minus 6, and delta U is you have to find out. Okay, in this problem, U1 and delta U you have to find. Once you apply the formula, Q equals to delta U plus W for the process B, nothing but U2 minus U1 plus W. Q is given, that is 15. Okay, U2 minus U1. Okay, U2 is given minus 6. You have to substitute minus 6 and minus U1. U1 is unknown thing here. Okay, minus U1 and plus W. W is given minus 6. Okay, minus means work is done on the system. Plus indicates the work done by the system. Okay, so Q equals to U2 minus U1 plus W. Q is 15 given and U2 is minus 6. U1 is minus U1 plus 6. Okay, from this one you have to find out unknown things. That is, U1 you are getting it as 15 plus 6, 20. You are getting 27 equals to minus U1. So U1 is minus 21. Okay, once again, sign convention is most important here. Okay, why is minus sign? What is the indication of minus sign? Anybody? U1 is minus 27. What it indicates? Anybody? What is minus sign in U1? Okay. How we are having W negative means work done on the system, positive means work done by the system, like that. U1 equals to minus indicates there will be a decrease in the internal energy at the state 1. Okay. And positive sign indicates the increase in the internal energy at that particular state point. So you remember sign convention also most important. So whenever heat added to the system is positive, whenever heat is taken from the system is negative, work done on the system is negative, work done by the system is positive, like that. So suppose you are getting U2 minus U1 as negative, you see U2 minus U1 as negative means there will be a decrease in the internal energy. And positive indicates increase in the internal energy. Similarly, for the process C, you see the table. The values given are Q is minus 7, W is 10, U1 is 20, U2 is unknown thing, and delta U is unknown thing. Like that, they can ask any quantities. In the process C, three known quantities, Q, W, and U1, and unknown quantities, U2 and delta U. Okay, for process C, you apply same thing, Q equals to delta U. For the process C, Q equals to delta U plus W. Q is minus 7. Minus indicates the heat rejected. Heat rejected from the system. And U2, unknown things. U2 is unknown thing here for the process C. Minus U1. U1 is given. That is 20. And delta U is W is 10 given in the problem. So, unknown thing is U2. U2 equals to 3 kilojoules. Next, our aim is to find out. Once you know the U2, you have to find out delta U. Delta is nothing but U2 minus U1. U2 is 3 and U1 is 20. 3 minus 20 will get, U2 minus U1 is 20. So U2 is 3 kilojoules. Delta U equals to U2 minus U1. That is 3 minus of 20. Okay. So minus 17 kilojoules you get. Finally, last process. Process D. Okay. Process D, Q equals to, Q is unknown thing. We have to find out W is minus 7. U1 is unknown thing. And U2 is given 8. And delta U is minus 20. Unknown thing is Q and U1. So Q equals to delta U plus W. Okay. So for the process D, delta U equals to, first you have to find out U2 minus U1. Already we know the values, that is 8 minus U1 equals to minus 20. Okay. So you get U1 as 28 kilojoules. Okay. Next, you have to find out Q. Q equals to what? Delta U plus W. Delta U is nothing but U2 minus U1. U2 minus U1 is minus 20 given in the problem, minus 20, okay, plus W is minus 7, okay, minus 20, minus 7, you get minus 27 kilojoules. Like that, you have to find out, we have to remember very simple formula, that is Q equals to delta U plus W, and remember, delta U is nothing but U2 minus U1. Okay. And suppose, if you are going to analyze whether your values are correct or not, in that case you have to check, that is summation of Q equals to summation of W. Okay, summation of Q is nothing but what? 35 plus 50, 15, that is 50, 50 minus 7, 43, 43 minus 27. Okay, so like that you can analyze, and delta W also same. Okay, so you can calculate and you'll get the same value, that is delta Q equals to delta W. Whether your answer is correct or not, in that case you have to check. So you have to check the first law of thermodynamics, that is 35 plus 50, okay, 15, that is totally 50, 50 minus 34, 50 minus 34, nothing but 16. Okay, now here also you can check it out, 20 plus 30, 30, 30 minus 13. Okay, now actually it is not actually a cyclic process, it is the another process, that is undergoing change of state. In a cyclic process, summation of Q is summation of W. Okay, next problem I'll explain. This is another important problem. Okay, you see the statement: a fluid system contained in a piston and cylinder machine passes through a complete cycle of four processes. You see, in the previous problem they are not given any cyclic process. Okay, in this problem it is a cyclic process. Cyclic process means summation of Q equals to summation of W. The sum of all heat transferred during a cycle is minus 340 kilojoules. Summation is nothing but what? Q1 plus Q2 plus Q3 plus Q4 is minus 340 kilojoules. Minus indicates the heat rejected from the system. And the system completes 200 cycles per minute. Okay, so that in a minute there will be 200 cycles. Okay, so next, complete the following table showing the method for each atom and compute the net rate of work output in kilowatts. Okay, they are given the net heat transfer. Our aim is to find out the net work output. You see, so this is the table they will give like this. In the using this one, we have to find out the summation of the work transfer. Okay, so process, you see, process 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, and finally 4 to 1. So it is a cyclic process. Cyclic process means the initial and final states are identical. Okay, once again, in this problem, so Q is given, that is 0. Process from 1 to 2, it is 0. Process 2 to 3, it is 42,000. Process 3 to 4, it is minus 4,200. And process 4 to 1 is, we have to find out actually, it's the unknown thing. You remember, this is the dash actually. So this is dash, we have to find out what is the heat transfer during process 4 to 1. Similarly, W is given. Okay, for the process 1 to 2 is, it is 4340. Process 2 to 3, it is 0. Process 3 to 4, it is 69,000. And process 4 to 1 is, once again, it is unknown thing. Okay, so we have to find out these values. And also, we have to find out the total work done. And delta E, as I said, for internal energy, either you can use the symbol U or E. Both are same. Okay, in some problems they use E, but meaning is same. E and U indicates internal energy. Okay, and for process 1 to 2, it is unknown thing. Okay, we have to find out what is the delta E for process 1 to 2. Delta E for process 2 to 3 is also unknown thing. And these values given, minus 73,200 kilojoules for process 3 to 4. And for process 4 to 1 is also unknown thing. Okay, so what are the unknown things? Q for 4 to 1, and then W for 3 to 4, and W for 4 to 1, delta E for 1 to 2. Delta E for 2 to 3. So these are the unknown things. So using this table, you have to complete the table using the formula. Okay, as it is given, that is the net, the summation of all heat transfer during the cycle is minus 340 kilojoules. Okay, first you have to write the given data. Summation of Q equals to minus 340 kilojoules given in the problem. Number of cycles, 200 cycles per minute. Number of cycles is in a minute, in 1 minute there will be 200 cycles. Okay, there are 200 times cyclic process takes place in 1 minute, that is the meaning. Next, we have to apply the formula for process 1 to 2. Okay, Q 1 to 2 is delta E. Delta E is nothing but E2 minus E1 plus W1 to 2, or we can write Q 1 to 2 equals to delta E plus W1. Okay, so Q1 to 2 is 0. So what is the meaning of 0? it may be adiabatic process. Adiabatic process means there is no heat transfer. Okay, that's why it is given zero. Okay, you remember, in case of adiabatic process, there is no heat transfer at all. Right, Q is zero. Zero, delta E, as it is, we don't know. We have to find out delta E. W, 1 to 2 is given. It is how much? 4340. From this one, we have to find out delta E. Delta E is nothing but minus 4340 kilojoules per minute. Very simple. Just to substitute the value, you will get delta E as minus 4340 kilojoules per minute. Okay. Once again, negative sign indicates that there will be a decrease in the internal energy. This is for process 1 to 2. Once you know the value, just you substitute those values in the table. Next, for the process 2 to 3. For the process 2 to 3, once again you apply the formula Q 2 to 3 equals to delta E for the process 2 to 3 and W. So, process 2 to 3 is 42,000 given. Okay. Next, delta E. So we have to find out, and W is zero. Anybody tell me what kind of process it is? W is zero. Where will get W is zero? Anybody? Anyone?
Adiabatic.
No. W is zero in case of constant volume process. That's why I said you should remember certain values. Okay, you remember. Q is zero for adiabatic process. Constant volume process. W will be zero. Like that. For certain things you have to remember. Okay. So some of the times they won't give the data. You have to analyze the data and you have to put. Okay. Here process 2 to 3 indicates for this is a constant volume process because W is zero. Okay. Where you get W is zero? In case of isochoric process, and process 1 to 2 is your adiabatic process. Like that you have to analyze. Okay. 42,000 delta E is unknown thing. Once again in process 2 to 3 and W 2 to 3 is 0. So after solving you get Q 1 to 2 is plus. You see in the previous case we got minus and in second case we got plus. Plus indicates the there will be heat added to the system. Okay, so plus indicates there will be heat addition takes place. Okay, this is a process 2 to 3. Next, process 3 to 4. Okay, in the process 3 to 4, Q is given, delta E is given, unknown thing is our W. Okay, so apply the same formula. Process 3 to 4, Q is given how much? Minus 4200. Okay, delta E is given minus 73,200 and plus W. So after solving, you'll get 73,200 minus of 4,300, 200. You'll get 69,000 kilojoules per minute. Okay. So we solved all the things. Now, okay, but for the process 4 to 1 is unknown thing, but total amount of the heat transfer given in the problem minus 340 kilojoules. Okay, that is Q1 to 2 plus Q2 to 3. Plus Q34 plus Q41 is nothing but minus 340 kilojoules. Okay, and unknown thing is in for the process 4 to 1, unknown thing is Q. We have to find out Q. And one more important thing is here they are given summation of Q and number of cycles are given. If it is one cycle, no problem. Directly you can take minus 340. Whenever 200 cycles are there, in that case, you have to multiply by this value with 200. That is summation of the heat transfer equals to minus 340 into 200. You remember, suppose you take minus 340 wrong because in the problem they are given total 200 cycles are there. You have to multiply by this value with total number of cycles. That is minus 340 into 200. So minus 68,000 kilojoules per minute of the total heat transfer takes place in all the cycles. Okay, and one cycle it is minus 340. Okay, now using this one you have to find out unknown thing is Q41. You write Q1 to 2 plus Q2 to 3 plus Q34 plus Q41 is nothing but minus 68,000, and you have to substitute all the values. That is using this one we have to find out Q4. And Q1 to 2 is 0. Q2 to 3 is 42,000. Q3 to 4 is -4,200. Unknown thing is Q4 1 equals to -68,000. Unknown thing is Q4 1. After solving, you'll get the Q4 1 as -105,800 kilojoules. Okay, so this is a kilojoule unit. So how to find out Q4 1? So in the process 4 to 1, all our unknown things you remember. Okay, we have to find out Q4 1, we have to find out W4 1, we have to find out delta E. First step, we found out the value of Q. The value of Q is nothing but the summation of -68,000 kilojoules per minute. Okay, once again, be careful about plus and minus sign. So whatever minus you see, what they have given, the whole heat transfer during the cycle is -340. So you have to take minus only. Okay. So after solving, you will get the value of Q4 1 as -105,800. Then next step, how to find out your W. Okay, as I said, in a cyclic process, the summation of Q and summation W are same, because for a closed system undergoing in a cyclic process, the summation of heat transfer equals to summation of work transfer for a closed system undergoing a cyclic process. Okay, and then whatever value we got, -68,000, is same as that of summation of W. Okay, you take summation of Q equals to summation of W, that is -68,000. Okay, once you know this one, we are having the remaining things we know. We know W1 to 2, we know W2 to 3, we know W3 to 4. Unknown thing is our W4 1, but summation of W is same as that of summation of Q. Okay, now same principle you follow here. Okay, you will get the net work done. Okay, net work done is using that one, we can find out the value of W41 is -141,340 kilojoules. Okay, and unknown thing is delta U. Apply the formula, Q equals to delta U plus W. Now we got Q, we got W. Using that formula, we can find out delta E as 35,540. So like that, you can find out. Any doubt in this problem? So just you remember a simple formula, Q equals to delta U plus W. There is a formula, that's it. And delta U is nothing but final state minus initial state. So next, rate of work output they asked. One more, you see the last part, compute the net rate of work output in kilowatts. Kilowatt is nothing but kilojoules per second. So we got kilojoules per minute. Summation of Q is summation of W in case of a cyclic process, -68,000, just Q divided by 60. Whatever we got, this is in kilojoules per minute. In order to find out kilojoules per second, just you divide this value by 60. You get 1133.33 kilowatt. This much amount of the work output you will get. Rate means what? Divided by time, that is second. 8,000 divided by 60, you get 1133.33 kilowatts. So such kind of problem will ask for 10 marks. Okay, understand the concept properly. So we have to find out this value. Understood, guys? Any doubts in this problem? Any doubt? Any doubt?
No, sir.
Okay. I'll continue another problem. Okay. Okay, now I'll explain one of the most important problems. Once you understand the concept, then only you can solve such kind of the problem. Okay, you see that, you read the problem number 4. Okay, so one of the important problem, quite understanding and interesting problem. Okay, when the state of system changes from state 1 to state 2 along the path 1 to 3. Okay, you see, first you analyze that diagram. This is the PV diagram you have to analyze. Okay, this is once again a cyclic process. You see, there are two cyclic process, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, and 3 to 1 follows the path A. Okay, and one more is there. Okay, 1 to 4, 4 to 3, and 3 to 1. Okay, there are two cyclic process are there. Okay, there are two paths. Okay, 1 2 3 1. You see, 1 2 3 1, 1 2 3 A 1, and another process 1 4 3 A 1. Okay, there are two cyclic process are there. Okay, you were having one more curve is there. Okay, A. So you see, there are two cyclic process, 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to A, and then 3 to 1 by following path A. Another cyclic is process there, 1 4 3 A 1. Okay, this is a two cyclic process. Okay, you see, when the state of the system changes from state 1 to state 2 along the path 1, 2, 3 as shown in the figure, okay. 1, 2, 3, 1. And another one is 1, 4, 3. Along the path 1, 2, 3 as shown in the figure, 80 kilojoule of heat flows into the system and system do 30 kilojoule of work, okay. So, here for the process, cyclic process 1, 2, 3, 1, okay. 80 kilojoule of heat enters into the system and 30 kilojoule of the work done by the system. They are given these two values, that is Q and W they are given. Next, how much amount of the heat flows into the system along the path 1, 4, 3. Okay, now they are asked how much amount of the heat flows into the system along the path 1, 4, 3. Okay. So here the heat transfer for the process 1, 2, 3, 1 is given 80 kilojoule. Our aim is to find out how much amount of the heat transferred for the path 1, 4, 3, 1. Okay. How much amount of heat flows into the system along the path 1, 4, 3 if work done by the system is 10 kilojoules. Okay. First, you analyze the problem. Okay, how much amount of heat flows into the system along the path 1, 4, 3 if work done by the system is 10 kilojoules is given. Okay. Second part, when the state of the system is returned from state to 1 along the third path, the work done on the system is 20 kilojoules. Okay, so we'll go one by one. Okay, first we'll solve the part A. Okay, otherwise we'll get confused. We'll go one by one. Okay, so first you take the process 1 to 2 to 3. Okay, now you have to apply the first law of thermodynamics. What is Q1 to 3? So you see, Q1 3 is nothing but Q3 minus C1. Okay, don't take Q2 minus C1 because we are considering here it as for the process 3 to 1. That's why you write Q1 to 3 is nothing but final internal energy minus initial internal energy plus W1 to 2. And from the data, they are given what is the heat transfer for the process 1 to 3 is 80 kilojoule is given. We don't know U3 minus U1. Okay. And W1 to 2, 3 is plus 31. So you see, the 80 kilojoule of heat flows into the system and the system do 30 kilojoule of work. Okay. Sign convention are most important here. You have to take plus 30 because work done by the system. Okay, Q1 to 2, 3 is 80, U3 minus U1. Okay, plus 30. Okay, from this one you have to find out U3 minus U1. It is 80 minus 30. You'll get 50 kilojoules. Okay, you go one by one. First, you take the process 1 to 3. Apply first law of thermodynamics. Q13 equals to U3 minus U1. That is nothing but delta U. Plus W1 to 2, 3. Q13 is given plus 80 kilojoules. You see, heat entered into the system. That's why you have to take a positive sign. Okay. U3 minus U1. unknown thing plus 30 is 30. Okay, here formula is very simple, but sign convention is most important. Suppose you take minus wrong. Here also, suppose you take minus wrong. That's why before solving any problem, you should understand whether it is heat entered or rejected, and work done on the system or by the system. Okay, so only that words you should remember, and you have to take the sign accordingly. So you'll get U3 minus U1 as 50 kilojoule. This is the first part. Okay. Next, we have to take, now I'm taking process path. I'm taking 1, 4, 4, 3, and 3, 1. Okay. So how you're getting? So Q13 along the path 1, 4, 3. Q13 is U3 minus U1 plus W13. So Q13 is U3 minus U got, and here W13 is given 10. Okay. So now, as I said, we can take the path A using 1A, 3, 1 or 1, 4, 3, 1. This A is common path, remember. So I can apply for this cyclic process. Q13 is nothing but what? U3 minus U1 plus W13. Okay. So in the problem, they are given how much amount of the heat flows into system along the path 1, 4, 3 if work done by system is 10 kilojoule. Okay. Just now we found out U3 minus U1. W13 is positive, that is plus 10. So Q13 is 50. 50 we got plus 10. So you'll get Q13 as plus 60 kilojoule. Okay. Once again, the heat is added to the system for the process 1, 2, 3. Okay. So first you find out U3 minus U1. So now you take the process 1, 4, 3, apply the first law of thermodynamics, you will get Q13 as 60 kilojoule. Positive sign indicates the work done by the system. Okay. Next, what they asked, part B, you see, hope you understood part A, that is how much amount of heat flows when the work done by the system is 10 kilojoule. Now you read the second part, that is part B. When the state of the system is returned from state 3 to state 1 along the curved path, work done on the system is 20 kilojoule. Though the system absorbs or liberates the heat, find its magnitude. Second part, when the system is returned from state 3 to state 1, okay, now you have to take process 3A1, okay, apply the first law of thermodynamics, that is Q31. So previously we took 1, 2, 3, now you have to take 3, 1, okay, just you change the order, okay, 3A1 is nothing but, so Q31 equals to delta U. What is delta U? In the previous case, it is U3 minus U1. In this case, you have to take U1 minus U3. Okay, because it is final state minus initial state. For the process 3 to 4, delta U is U1 minus U3. Don't take U3 minus U1. So, change in internal energy is always final internal energy minus initial internal energy. So, U 3-1 is nothing but U1 minus U3. That's why you take same thing along the path. You see the part B, U1 minus U3 is a delta U, that is Q31. Okay, Q31 minus of W31. Okay, it's nothing but Q31 equals to delta U plus W31. Same thing we have put it in this order, that is U1 minus U3 equals to Q31 minus W31. Don't take 1-3. Okay. Here also don't take 1-3. Here U1 minus U3 is Q31 minus W3. Now Q31. Our aim is to find out what is the heat transfer for the process 3 to 1. That is nothing but U1 minus U3 plus W31. Okay. W31 we are given in the problem. 20 kilojoule of work is done on the system, you see. The work done on the system, that's why you have to take negative sign. Okay, U1 minus U3, already we know U3 minus U1 is plus 50. So U1 minus U3 is nothing but minus 50. Just you change the sign. U3 minus U1 is plus 50. So u1 minus u3 is nothing but minus 50 plus w. Okay, plus w means you have to take minus 20. Minus is work done on the system is 20 kilojoule. So after solving, we'll get the heat transfer during the process process 3:1. We are getting it as minus 70 kilojoule. They asked, does the system absorbs or liberates the heat and find its magnitude? Anyhow, we found out the magnitude as 70. Okay, and sign is minus. Minus indicates the heat is liberated from the system, that you have to mention. Okay, if it is positive, then you have to mention it as the heat is added to the system. If it is minus, you have to write it as the heat is liberated from the system. Okay, whatever problem I am explaining is the most important problem. Try to understand, okay, concept. But formula is only one formula you are using, that is Q equals to delta U plus W. But you have to take in a proper way, okay, then only you get the correct magnitude and plus or minus. This is the second part. First part over, that is U1 minus U3. First class. Okay. Along the path 3A1. So U1 minus U3 equals to Q31 minus W31. Okay. So Q31 is, we are getting minus 70 kilojoules. So the negative sign indicates that the heat is liberated from the system. This is the second point. And third part, okay, you see, this third part is most important. If U1 is 0 and U4 is 40 kilojoule, okay. If U1 is 0 and U4 is 40 kilojoules, find the heat absorbed in the process 1 to 4 and 4 to 3 respectively. Two values are given, okay, U1 and U4. Find the heat absorbed in the process 1, 4 and 4, 3, okay. You see the last part, along the path 1, 4, okay. So you have to apply the first law of thermodynamics. What is along the path 1-4? Q14 equals to U4 minus U1. Okay. So once again, same formula you apply. Q14 equals to delta U. Delta U is nothing but U4 minus U1 plus W14. Same formula apply. And U4 is given 40. And U1 is 0. Okay. U1 is 0 given in the problem. You see, U1 is 0 and U4 is given in the problem. Okay. So Q14 equals to U4 minus U1 plus W14. So 40 minus 10 plus W14 is 10. 10 is given in the problem, you see. So U1 is 0, U4 is 40 kilojoule. Okay. And already work done by system is 10 kilojoule. You refer the part A, that is for 10 kilojoule given in the problem. U4 minus U1 is 40 minus 0 plus 10. W14 already we know, that is 10 kilojoule. Okay. So otherwise, what you can do, W143. Okay, you take this process. So there are two processes, W14 plus W43. As I said, the work done during process 4 to 3 is 0. Okay, directly you can take 0. So only whatever W143 is nothing but W143 is nothing but W14, because there is no work done during the constant volume process. So you see, same thing, you see the bracket. W143 is W14 plus W43. W14 is 10 kilojoule given in the problem. And W43. That's why I said you should remember certain concept. Work done during constant volume process is 0, okay, and get 10. So W14 we took it as 10. So after solving, the amount of the heat transferred in the process 1 to 4, it is 50 kilojoules. Okay, the positive sign indicates the heat is absorbed by the system. Okay, next. Now so now you consider Q3 to 4. Okay. We got Q14. Now next, Q43. Same thing you have to apply the first law of thermodynamics, that is Q43 is nothing but U3 minus U4, final internal energy minus initial internal energy plus W43. Okay. Now U3 minus U4. U3 minus U4. So now we apply. Our aim is to find out what is the heat transfer during the process 4-3. That is Q 4-3 equals to U3 minus U4 plus W 4-3. So U3 is nothing but 50. Just now we got, you see U3 is 50 kilojoule. Okay, where you got U3 is 50, here it is there. Okay. So U3 is 50 kilojoules. Okay. And then U4 is 0. 0 given in the problem. So U4 is U. No, sorry. U4 is 40, U3 is 50, U4 is 40, and W3 to 4 is 0. Okay, so you get Q34 as 10 kilojoules. Now we found out two values. Q14 is 50 kilojoule and Q43 is 10 kilojoules. And now what is the total heat transfer? Okay, total heat transfer is Q14 plus Q4 plus Q31. Okay, so you have to sum up. It is equals to W14 plus W43 plus W31. So you can analyze and you have to equate the values. Okay. So in this problem, it is very interesting to understand the constant volume process. Then curved path, you see, such kind of path we didn't get till now. Okay, so here we can take the closed cyclic process in any path, 1, 2, 3, 1 by following path A. I can take another process, 1, 4, 3, 1 by following path A. I'm using the common path A, but there are two cyclic processes and the amount of heat transfer and the work done are different in different processes. Okay, so you have to basically remember the formula. That is, when we are going to apply first law of thermodynamics in a cyclic process, when we have to apply the first law of thermodynamics for the change of state, you see 1, 2, 3, 1 is a cyclic process, whereas 1, 2, 2 is only a process. Okay, that is the difference between a cyclic process and a thermodynamic process. So in a cyclic process, the summation of W and summation of Q are same, but for a thermodynamic process, the work done and the heat transfer are different. You remember, only in case of cyclic process, summation of work done and summation of heat transfer are same, and for a thermodynamic process, the work done and heat transfer are different. Okay. So this is one of the important problems. Do you have any doubts in this problem, guys? Any doubts? Any doubts? Have you understood the concepts properly, how to start and how to get the values? Suppose if you are having any doubts in any process, please ask me. Such kind of problems you'll get in the competitive examinations like GATE and other things. Okay, so in the university exams also, so go through such kind of problems. Understood, guys, this problem? Okay. Any doubts in this problem? As I said, the internal energy is a property of the system. Okay, so internal energy, like how we are having the thermodynamic properties, pressure, volume, and temperature, like that. The internal energy is also a property. All the properties are point functions. On the other hand, work done, heat transfer are path functions. Okay, the point functions are the exact differential. For example, integration of delta V equals to V2 minus V1. Integration of dt is T2 minus T1. Like that, integration of U2 minus U1 is also, it is a property. Okay. On the other hand, the work done and heat transfer are the path function. They do not depend upon the end states. Rather than, they depends upon the entire path followed during the process. Okay, we can write integration of dv as v2 minus v1, and but on the other hand, we cannot write integration of dw as w2 minus w1, you remember, because it is a path function. But then how we are going to write integration of dw is w1 to 2, because it, the process takes place from state 1 and it ends at state 2. So you have to represent w as w1 to 2, or the heat transfer as q1 to 2. Okay. And cyclic integral of any property is zero. You remember, cyclic integration of dt is zero, cyclic integration of dv is zero, and cyclic integration of du is zero, because cyclic integral of any property is zero. Cyclic process means what? It is the initial and final states are same. Cyclic integration of dt means t2 minus t1. For cyclic process, it is zero. But for open process, it is not zero. Integration of dt is just t2 minus t1. But for whenever the term comes cyclic integral, you have to take zero. Cyclic integral of any properties, zero. So the path functions are inexact differentials. The point functions are the exact differential. Point functions are pressure, volume, temperature, internal energy, etc. Path functions are work done, heat transfer, etc. Okay. So in this chapter, please go through what is first law of thermodynamics, statement of first law of thermodynamics, Joule's experiment to illustrate the first law of thermodynamics, concept of internal energy, perpetual motion machine of first kind. Then we studied a steady state, steady flows type. Steady flow means all the thermodynamic properties are invariant with time. Okay, they will not vary according to the time. Okay, so we derived the most important concept, that is steady flow energy equation. Okay, so kindly go through this derivation, most important derivation, and how we are going to apply this steady flow energy equation for various devices. Like turbine, compressor, then heat exchanger, condenser, nozzle, etc. Okay, so try to practice all this derivation. Okay, definitely they will ask either steady flow energy equation or steady flow energy equation applications. So this is one of the important concept in the first law of thermodynamics. Hope you understood all the concepts. Now I'll stop the session. Thank you for joining.